Thank you. Good morning, dear families, and welcome to St. Edward Catholic Church and to the celebration of the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. As you probably have heard, we have entered an exciting season of Eucharistic revival. God is unleashing fresh grace upon our community through this movement, and we want you to join us in this powerful new chapter. We are inviting you to participate in the teaching, Jesus and the Eucharist, today at 5 p.m. We will be learning about the story of the Eucharist. We look forward to seeing you. Today, we invite you to come and pray the Divine Mercy Chaplet at 3 p.m. in the church. All are welcome. Please silence your phones at this time to respect the sacredness of the Mass. The celebrant for this Mass is Father John. Have a blessed Divine Mercy Sunday.
Please stand.
Our God is good, who's loving.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Please turn towards one another and say good morning to him or her.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. This is the day the Lord has made, and be glad in it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, coming together as one family, coming together as community of St. Edward's, let us acknowledge our sins and so to prepare ourselves to celebrate the secret mysteries. I confess
and to my brothers and sisters that I have really sinned
in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do.
My fault.
Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me, to our God.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Of everlasting mercy, who in the very reoccurrence of the Paschal feast kindled the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed, through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them and bring the proceeds of the sale and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey His commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep His commandments. And His commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm also doing great. Thank you for responding with all your boldness that you can talk about. I'm so happy to see you today. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
My dear family of God, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Today,
It's the second Sunday of Easter. And every second Sunday of Easter, the Catholic Church celebrates Divine Mercy Sunday. So today is two in one. Second Sunday of Easter and Divine Mercy Sunday. From the gospel reading of today, my dear family of God, when Jesus first saw his own people, the disciples, he said to them, "Peace be with you." And he repeated it three times. As we celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday today, as a community of St. Edward's, we must be united as believers and continue to express the joy and faith in the risen Christ. United as a community of believers, we must always express our joy and our faith in Christ. Because today is the day the Lord has made. My dear family of God, from the first reading of today from the Acts of the Apostles, it summarizes the way the early Christian community lived and testified to the risen Lord through their way of life, by sharing love together, being compassionate, merciful towards one another. The early Christian community, they were showing love to one another. They were showing community mercy to one another. And then they were doing things in common that none of them considered himself or herself richer than the other. But the question I have for all of us this morning is, how do we see ourselves today? Are we behaving like the early Christian community, the people that they were there at that time? Or we are living alone? Are we trying to learn from them? Or whom are we learning from? During that time, if you sell your car, if you sell any property, you don't own the money, you send the money to the leader. For example, if you sell your car or your house, you bring the money to Father Albert. And then you say to Father, "Father, take this money, share with the other community members who are in need." Can we do that today? If the answer is no, the question is, why can't we do it? We cannot do it simply because now we live individuals. We are individuals. We are no more community. We live in individualistic community. But during the early Christian time, they were living in community. They know each other. For example, if I ask you to mention two names or three names outside your own family in this church, can you be able to mention three names? Can you? If the answer is yes, if I ask you to mention five, can you mention five? If I ask you to mention 10, are you sure you will not fumble with the names? My dear family of God, Jesus wants all of us to be united. That is why I began by saying, united as community of believers. So are we united? Do we know each other's problems? Do we know the difficulties each of us goes through? How many times after Mass have you stand outside and say good morning to friends here? How many times do you do that? Most of the time we say, oh, Community of St. Edward's, but immediately after Mass, show, everybody going, within 5 minutes, the whole place is empty. Are we community members? My dear family of God, if Jesus say yes, no one can say no. If today the readings is telling you and me that the early Christian community, they live their life as truly community members, then what can we do? All that I'm urging all of us to do is after Mass, have time to ask somebody, how are you? What is your name? Where do you live? What work do you do? Can you visit me? Can I visit you? That makes us a community. But community doesn't mean hi. Gone, no. That is not the community the first reading is talking about. The community is a community whereby we know each other's problems, whereby we know where each other person lives. When someone dies, we know someone has died. But the community we have today, my dear family of God, we cannot talk about it. Are we united? Are we living individually, or we are living as community? Each one for himself and God for us all. That is the saying. If truly we live as community, we will know each other's problem. But we live as individuals. And because of that, we used to say, each one for himself, but God for us all. Is that how the community life should be? My dear family of God, in the second reading of today, Jesus talks about so many things. As community members, what were they keeping them together? In the early Christian community, they derived their strength from community prayer, the breaking of bread, and the word of God. They were united because of three things: community prayer, breaking of bread, and the word of God. Today, soon, we are all going to share the breaking of the bread in communion. The word of God, we are listening. What about community prayer? Do you belong to any cell group whereby you meet and talk about God? Which group do you belong to? As a community, anytime we call upon the community to come together, do you form part of it? For example, this afternoon at 3 p.m., we are all coming back to recite the Divine Mercy Prayer. Are you going to be part of that community? At 5 p.m., we are coming back for the Eucharistic revival. It is the community calling. Are you going to be part of it? We have 7 sessions of the community prayer and the Eucharistic revival, 7 times. Today is going to be the 6th time. Have you been part of it before? 5 have gone. We have left with 2. Are you going to be part? If you haven't been here, make sure you come today, because we are talking about how the community of early Christian people, they lived their life. They came together as one people. They prayed together as common people. They shared the bread together as common people. And then they show compassion to one another. They show mercy to one another. They think they are one people. Is that how we see today? The church will call you, come, and you say no. The church invites you, come and become members of us. You said no. What are we looking for? Is that the only thing, is to come to Mass on Sundays? That's it? And you say, I'm a member of St. Edward's. If you want to be a good Christian, a good member of St. Edward's. We have masses on Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Saturday we say rest. Do your washings, cook your food, and come back again on Sunday. And the Luther continua. We move on again. Are you part of that masses? My dear family of God, try as much as possible to join a cell group so that you can practice the breaking of bread, so that you can share your love, so that you can share your compassion and your mercy to one another. Coming back to the church, let us show compassion to one another. Let us be merciful, because the Lord said, "Learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart." Is that what we are doing, my dear family of God? Is that what we are practicing, my dear people of God? This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it by participating in the community things. People of God, the second reading from St. John urges all of us to be obedient to the commandments of the Lord. To be obedient to the commandments of the Lord. And he mentioned only one commandment: love of your neighbor. And are we doing that? Jesus is indeed risen from the dead. He brought life. And now, is that what we are doing? Do we love your neighbor? Many of us will say, "Oh, Father John, I love God, but I hate my neighbor." What does the Bible say? It says you're a liar. How many of us have seen God in their lives? But day in and day out, you see your neighbor and you say, "I hate him or her." Why are you saying this? And remember, God created man in his own image. And if you love me, you love God. If you hate me, you hate God. So what are we doing? As community, why hatred continues to move on? As members, why can't we love one another? By visiting, by showing, compassionate, be merciful, and showing love to one another. This is what St. John in the second reading is telling us. Loving others as Jesus loves us demands that we treat others with Jesus' mercy and compassion. How do you treat your neighbor? When you are passing by and people stand there, what do they talk about you? In your own community, how do people see you? Do you greet people when you are going for work? In your own jobs, how do people see you? How do people talk about you? My dear family of God, this is the crucial time in our life that Jesus wants all of us to show love to one another. There shouldn't be a barrier between showing your love to me and to others.